videos, we don't reveal any addresses, and even though I've done a house tour of my own place, please do not show up at any private residences because it's not safe for anyone. Jamie Lee Curtis and her longtime husband, Christopher Guest, have been living in the very same Los Angeles home since they fell in love with it back in the early 90s. The couple renovated and customized their home over the years, and these days, the Spanish Colonial Revival style estate also offers a modern aesthetic inside. In 2016, Jamie Lee and her husband further added on to their property, buying up the neighbor's home for $2.2 million. Way back in 1992, Jamie Lee Curtis and Christopher Guest would set their eyes on what would become their beloved family home. The couple has been happily living here for about 3 decades now, adding on to the property with the purchase of a neighboring home in 2016. Since 1992 was a long time ago, there's no word on how much Jamie Lee paid for her Spanish Colonial Revival abode. We do know that at the time of purchase, the estate, which dates back to 1929, needed some work, and the actress set out to customize the place to her liking. Jamie and Christopher's home is located in Santa Monica, reportedly in a canyon in West Los Angeles, and when they first saw the place, it seemed dark inside and was full of antiques. Jamie claimed many of the rooms, such as the traditional kitchen, hadn't even been updated since it was built back in the 20s. She added about these features, "It was an upstairs, downstairs kind of house. It was designed for live-in help. It was very much a house for people to be served in. While there was a lot to be done, Jamie knew that even then the home could be wonderful." She recalled this memory to Architectural Digest, saying, "I'm one of those impulsive people. I believe that I can make almost any place lovely. I can make it a home. Almost any house I see, it's fabulous." Christopher, on the other hand, is very different when it comes to house hunting, but their current home was definitely an exception for her husband. When they were looking at the house to purchase, he first climbed onto a hill above the property and looked down towards it. Then he saw terracotta roof tiles and eucalyptus trees, which prompted him to say that they should buy it. Remembering this time, Christopher said about the grounds, "It felt like a park-like setting. I was happy with that." Today, the home is dark and old no more. It has an airy feel throughout, and while it's quite modern in many spaces, there's still a warm and homey energy with lots of personal touches to show for Jamie and Christopher's family life. Jamie said during this 2002 interview with AD, "I'm gonna sound so pretentious, it's sick, but my goal for the house was to bridge something old and tired with a much more contemporary aesthetic, which is the way we live. It's the blending of these two elements, an old traditional Mediterranean house with a sort of Zen. The thing I'm proud of is that blending, which is very much a part of me." The couple certainly managed to make this stunning house a home, and right when you arrive at the Mediterranean style structure, you see this personality even in the front yard. There's a plaster statue here of a figure with a top hat holding a mallet by the front door, and a silly portrait of Christopher above, which is a prop from an old TV series. While Jamie Lee's family home is very casual and welcoming, it still took a ton of work to transform it into something so stylish. Before the couple moved in, they started to renovate it, upgrading the electrical and plumbing, and doing some cosmetic work. Then they worked with architect Michael B. Lehrer and transformed the formerly two-bedroom abode to large-scale renovations, changing the floor plan. In the first one, they added a child's bedroom and two new bathrooms, while another children's room in the home was reconfigured as well, and Jamie and Christopher's master suite and bath was too. Then, later on, a large part of the lower floor was renovated, taking that small kitchen and opening it up into a new and open space combined with a family area. From photos, we can see the main living room has soaring double-height ceilings, which are also wood-paneled and beamed, and there's a large fireplace on one wall with French doors on another and hardwood flooring underfoot. While there aren't too many furnishings here, the custom-made large pieces and uncluttered walls allow the original features, like the ceiling and angled fireplace, to stand out. Nearby, the dining room wasn't super fancy either, but it boasts the same hardwood flooring and French doors. For help with the interiors, Jamie turned to Jan McFarland Cox, an Idaho-based artist with whom the couple has worked with before on several places, including a cabin they owned in Idaho. For their both, they decided to emphasize this house's Mediterranean origins. Cox said, "I said, let's make the floors dark and the walls white and live with that." So, they went for a clean line design for the most part and used large, modern, and classic furnishings. Jamie has also admitted that she doesn't like a ton of furniture, and so they kept things more simple and spare. The kitchen with family area was definitely more zen after the renovations as before. Jamie said the space used to be a tiny kitchen, a tiny breakfast room, and a weird little guest room. The banquettes in here were designed by Cox and Curtis, and they have pull-out drawers which double as footstools. The updated kitchen blends into this functional area and breakfast nook seamlessly with space for the whole family. In the home, Jamie and Christopher also lovingly selected their photography collection and have those pieces on display, as well as items like a Chinese red lacquer chest, which was a giveaway at the Golden Globes, and an old collectible photo of Louise Rainer, an actress who lived in the house in the 1930s, along with a ton of mementos of the couple's families and children. More recently, we can see Jamie and Christopher are still happily living here as the actress shares snaps of her home life on social media from time to time. In recent years, it appears the kitchen was made even more white, and we can see it's a bright space with white walls, matching cupboards, and the same wooden flooring, along with a luxe marble island in the center. There are also motivational pieces of art throughout, one print reading, "Note to self, be kind, time, be kind." While Jamie and Christopher have spent years making this place their happy home, there is always more to be done. Christopher revealed a while back, "I think it's like anything, it's a work in progress. This house is going to keep living." In 2016, it was also reported that Jamie and her husband purchased the next door home for $2.2 million. Adding onto their property makes sense considering how long they've lived in the same house, and while there aren't photos or many details of the bonus estate, records show the home is a two-level residence spanning just over 1,900 square feet of space. It was built in 1987, boasting 3 beds, 2 baths, and out back, a swimming pool and garden. And before we wrap this house tour up in the spirit of our Scream Queen Jamie Lee and Halloween Ends, let's just see where the real house from the movie is located. Unlike many of today's horror flicks, the original Halloween from 1978 was filmed in a real house instead of a movie set. Word is that the one-time home of Michael Myers is 1000 Mission Street in South Pasadena, California. The home was recognized as a historic building and therefore hadn't been torn down, and aside from being the Halloween abode, this structure, built in 1888, was the city's first duplex, marking the arrival of settlers from Indiana. A little known fact is that the crew of Halloween had to fix up the house and whitewash the entire front to capture the opening scene where a young Michael Myers murders his older sister. The home was relocated at one point, thus the addition to the back for the filming of the movie had to be removed. But aside from that, it's the same as it did in the 1978 film. It's no longer a private residence, and along with interior modifications to convert the rooms into office rooms, the exterior of the house was given a facelift and painted light blue with red trim. Fans hoping to visit can still see the famed landmark from the exterior. All you do is get off the train at Mission Station and you're close by to the Mr. Myers former abode. Well, that's gonna bring this Jamie Lee Curtis house tour to a close. Let me know what your favorite part of her longtime home is, or if you'd prefer to visit the Halloween house instead. Thanks for tuning in. Please hit that subscribe button if you haven't. Follow me on Instagram to chat, and I'll catch you all in another video. Bye!